Robomate Plus, India's largest curriculum-based study app. Download the app now.
We are here with a brand new experiment. Now, what I have in front of me is a high-tension wire carrying a lot of current. Now, I'm going to try to walk on this and let's see what happens. Well, wait a minute. There's a bird also standing next to me on both its feet. Well, so am I, but we aren't getting a shock. Why is this happening?
Now here, I'm hanging on this wire which is carrying a lot of current in it, with my feet not touching the ground. But what you see is, I'm not getting a shock. So now let's understand how a human body gets a shock. Now here what you can see is there is a socket, right? The socket, it is in the range of 230 volts to 250 volts. And I'm standing on earth, and earth is at zero potential. We have already studied that. So basically what happens is, the human body is a very good conductor of electricity. So when I touch this socket, I'm acting like a wire between the socket and the earth. So the circuit gets completed and the current flows from higher potential to lower potential. Kids, you must have heard this, that you should never touch any electrical appliances barefooted. The reason is very simple. That means the socket was at higher potential, my body is acting like a wire, and when I'm touching it barefooted, my feet are directly in contact with the earth. And because of that, the circuit gets completed and the current flows through the body. So never touch any electrical appliances barefooted. Now here we have a circuit, and in the circuit, it consists of a battery and a bulb. And what you see is, the current flows from positive to negative and the bulb glows, right? Now, I cut the wire from this end, and what you all think is, the current is flowing from positive to negative, that means it should reach the bulb, right? But this doesn't happen. What you see is, the bulb is not glowing. The simple reason behind this is, the circuit is incomplete. For current to flow, the condition is, the circuit has to be completed from all sides. Now here, I am wearing a rubber sole shoes. Now I touch the socket, and again what you see is, now I don't get any shock. The answer is very simple. When I'm wearing a rubber sole shoes, the circuit breaks. And when the circuit breaks, even though I'm touching the socket, I'll not get any shock. It's very simple.
Hey Pooja.
Now kids, observe. I'm wearing a rubber sole shoes and he's barefooted. Who do you think will get a shock? Let's try. Now, what exactly happened here was, it is very simple. I was connected to the higher potential and he is directly connected to the earth, that means he is connected to the lower potential. So the circuit got completed and because of that the current started flowing and both of us got a shock. So isn't it very simple? So students, let's understand a very important 2 marks answer, that is, while working with electrical appliances, you should always wear a rubber soled footwear. The answer is very simple. The first point of the answer is, rubber is an insulator. Now we all know, if rubber is an insulator, it is a very bad conductor of electricity. That means rubber does not allow current to flow through it, and because of which circuit breaks and the current does not flow.
Thank you for watching this video lecture. To watch more such interesting videos, attempt tests and to get instant analysis, download the Robomate Plus app now.